Hello students and welcome back. Today's video is for class 8 and it's a continuation of the same poem that we had done last, Where the Mind is Without Fear by Rabindranath Tagore. In the last video, I explained to you all the entire poem line by line. In today's video, let us just look at some of the themes that Rabindranath Tagore has used in his poem. And before we move on to the themes, we'll have a look at the background of Rabindranath Tagore. Rabindranath Tagore was born on May 7, 1861 into a prosperous Bengali family in Calcutta. He was surrounded by artistic and intellectual pursuits of his elders. So the family members were into literature, into art. So they were basically very creative. Nobel laureate Tagore is recognized as a pioneer of Bengali literature, particularly the short stories. And is internationally acclaimed as one of the world's finest lyric poets. Now this poem, that is Where the Mind is Without Fear, was originally written in Bengali and was composed before India's independence in 1990. The original poem titled Prarthana was included in an anthology named Nevidya, and the poem was translated in English by Tagore himself in 1911 or around that time. Now, it was made a part of a collection of poems, and the book was named as Gitanjali, which was published in 1912. The poem has a special place in Tagore's heart as he recited the English version of it at the Indian National Congress session in Calcutta in 1917. In this poem, Rabindranath Tagore clearly expresses his philosophy about freedom, religion, nationalism and self-determinism. So basically what he wanted, what he aspired the nation to be like, how his view about religion, he's put it in his poem. He alluded to his preference for Muslim and Hindu unity in the poem. The students remember, during the time of independence or even before that, there was a lot of riots taking place between Hindus and Muslims, religious riots. And Rabindranath Tagore did not want these riots to, you know, increase or turn out to be a huge fight. He wanted Hindus and Muslims to come united, to be as one nation. He makes a prayer to God for his countrymen. Hence, he wrote this poem as a prayer to God for his nation and countrymen, so that there is peace, freedom, liberty to every citizen living in the country. I will just brush up upon the poem which we've already done in the previous video. So let's go line by line. Students, kindly open the book as I go through it. Where the Mind is Without Fear by Rabindranath Tagore. Where the mind is without fear and the head is held high, where knowledge is free. So basically what the poet is trying to tell us here is that every individual should have freedom to think, to act and speak. They should not be threatened by any kind of manipulation or any kind of pressure. So they should have the liberty to speak out what they feel or what they think. They should be who they are. One should be who he or she is. Should not try to be like someone else or try someone else to manipulate. Let someone else manipulate them. In the second line, he says, where knowledge is free. The line itself is very clear, where the poet says that every individual should get knowledge free. They should not be charged for it, or there should not be any discrimination in terms of gaining knowledge. No matter which caste, class or religion one belongs to, they should get the freedom of attaining the knowledge that they wish to get. The third line, where the world has not been broken up into fragments by narrow domestic walls. Here when he says narrow domestic walls, he means the walls that are created by us. By us as citizens, we've created a lot of walls between each individual, amongst ourselves, where we do not let anyone intrude in our space. So these walls, domestic walls, which is the religious discrimination, the caste discrimination, we should stop that. One should not discriminate the other in terms of their complexion, the color, the class, caste or religion. So that is basically what he's trying to say in the third line. There should not be any discrimination on the basis of caste, class or religion. In the fourth line he says, where words come out from the depth of truth. So basically what he's trying to say is, we should be all truthful. No matter what we say, no matter what we do, we need to be truthful, honest in whatever we are. The next line he says, where tireless striving stretches its arms towards perfection. So he says, we all have goals in our life and we all want to attain those goals. But what do we do to attain those goals? We need to work hard. One cannot just sit and say that I need this or I need that. We need to work hard in order to attain those goals, reach out to that destination. The next line, where the clear stream of reason has not lost its way into the dreary desert and the scent of death habit. So basically he says, we should know what we are saying. We should not get manipulated, nor should we believe in superstitions. So during that age, there were a lot of beliefs, superstitious beliefs that people believed in, which had some kind of political agenda, religious agenda, but they were superstitious beliefs, which people believed in. So Rabindranath Tagore is pleading and is requesting people not to believe in those superstitious beliefs, nor to get manipulated by people or the political parties or religious groups that were there during that time. Where the mind is led forward by thee. So here he says, thee means the ultimate God, the Almighty. He says, let God lead you forward to your destination. Let Him show you the path towards your destination, towards the goal that you want to achieve in your life. So he says, have strong faith in God. Into ever widening thought and action, into that heaven of freedom, my Father, let my country awake. So he says, this is my dream, to have a nation where people are awakened, where people know what they are doing, people are aware of what is right and what is wrong. So this is his aspiration of how he wants his country to be. So this was about the poem. Now let's move on to the central idea or theme that the poet has used in this poem. So basically, the poem is a prayer to God. The poet expresses his thoughts, expectations from his nation. He requests the God to create a nation, best and ideal, where all people are fearless, hardworking, truth, and lead with self-respect and dignity. So he says every individual should have liberty, freedom to do what they want, to speak what they want, to think what they want, and should not get manipulated by other people. And lastly, he says, where education is free for all, where people are not refrained from gaining education, where people are not biased, where everyone gets education the same way. It is his utopia. Now, utopia basically means a world that is created by oneself for himself, the way he imagines the world to be. So this is his own world. So he says it is his utopia in which he prays to God to let his country wake up to a blissful heaven of freedom, and that is his dream. So it is his dream to have a nation that is free from the clutches of irrational thoughts of violence, and he wants people to be to gain freedom, to gain liberty, where they can speak out what they want, do what they want. He does this without offending anyone. So this is something really important. Throughout the poem, if you have noticed, Rabindranath Tagore has not offended anybody. Neither has he offended any political party or any religion for that matter. So he has not offended anyone. At the same time, he's made a request to the people of the country, as well as the poem is like a prayer to God. He is asking God to give the kind of wisdom that people need to see what is best for them. In the present time, to conclude, this poem not only tells us about the horrible downtrodden position to which his country and his heritage was brought to, but also acts as a measure whether India has progressed any further after the country gained its independence. So here the poet is leaving us with a question, asking us whether even after so many years of independence, has our country gained freedom? Freedom from expressing oneself, freedom to think what they want, to say what they want, freedom from the clutches of the religious beliefs or the irrational beliefs, superstitious beliefs. So the poet is asking us a question. He wants us to analyze ourselves, our thoughts and the nation as a whole and understand whether the country has progressed towards better or not. So with this, students, we come to the end of the poem and the explanation of it. Students, kindly go through the poem and try to understand by yourselves what the poet is trying to say. Thank you very much.